We live in an expanding universe. Since the first moments of the Big Bang, the cosmos has been stretching out in every direction. So, if the universe is expanding now, it must have been smaller in the past, and everything in it must have been compressed into a smaller space. That, in essence, is the Big Bang theory, the idea that the universe was hotter, denser, and in some sense, smaller in the past. But what does that mean for us, living inside it? How do we know it's expanding? And where is all that space going? Let's start here. Our galaxy is a disk containing around 400 billion stars, and it's so large that it takes light about 100,000 years to cross it. As vast as the Milky Way is, it's only one of something like a trillion galaxies in our observable universe. Just a few of those galaxies could be seen from Earth, looking like fuzzy nebulae, before the advent of astronomical telescopes. But nearly as soon as we could make detailed observations of other galaxies, astronomers noticed something weird. Distant galaxies were all moving away from us. It was as though our galaxy was somehow cosmically unpopular. Now, you might be asking, if we can barely see these things, how do we know they're moving away from us? It has to do with what we call redshifting, a kind of Doppler effect of light. The same way that the sound of a siren drops in pitch when it's moving away from you, light that's moving away from you gets stretched out to longer wavelengths. For visible light, the longest wavelengths are red, so a white light that's moving away from you at a high enough speed will look reddened. The faster a star or galaxy is receding, the more its light is redshifted. In the 1920s, astronomers measured the redshifts of several distant galaxies and found that the farther away the galaxy, the faster it was moving away from us. At first, that might sound like we're at the center of some kind of powerful repulsion field. But really, it's exactly what you would expect to see if all galaxies are moving away from each other, which is what happens if the universe is expanding the same way in every direction. Here's how that kind of uniform expansion works. Let's say we take this slinky and stretch it out. The two closest rings went from being a millimeter apart to a centimeter, but the ends have gone from 5 centimeters apart to 50 in the same amount of time. Because they started farther apart, they're moving apart faster. If we were on this ring, we'd observe our neighbor ring moving away from us slowly, and the distant ones moving many times as fast. In cosmology, there's such a clear relationship between how far away a distant galaxy is and how fast it's receding from us, we use redshift as a way of talking about cosmic distances. But because light takes time to travel to us from distant galaxies, we also use redshift to talk about time. A galaxy with a high redshift is not only far away from us in space, it's far away in time. Its light has taken billions of years to reach us. Cosmology gives us an amazing opportunity to see the history of our universe directly. Every time we look into the cosmos, we're seeing stars as they were tens or hundreds of years ago, and other galaxies as they were millions or billions of years ago.
The universe at the very earliest moments must have been very hot and very dense, because all the matter and energy we can observe today in the vast universe must have been compressed to a very tiny volume. And so researchers think that the laws of nature behaved very differently at these times. For example, classical gravity must be replaced by a theory of quantum gravity. In my research, I investigate one of the most immediate candidate theories to quantum gravity, quantum geometrodynamics, which we were able to revive using new mathematical tools. New cosmological data will help us to discern the different theories and understand what theory describes best the universe at these earliest moments.
One thing I'm often asked is, if the universe is expanding, what is it expanding into? It's a hard question to answer because we're inside the universe. When we look out as far as we can see, we don't have any indication that there's an edge or any particular shape to the universe. It seems to just keep going. It's like being crammed inside a huge crowd at the end of a concert. Eventually, as people start leaving, the crowd thins and there's more space around you. And even if you can't see past everyone to know where they're going, you know that the crowd is spreading out. We know the universe is expanding because the stuff we can see inside it is getting farther apart. The density of matter is going down because there's the same amount of mass, but more volume. But in the case of the universe, there really might not be anything outside it. It might go on forever. The universe could be infinitely large and just getting more infinite. The way I think about it, the universe is expanding the way your mind is expanding. It's not expanding into anything. You're just getting less dense.